Today, I was reminded of my old Fortnite addiction. And thank God I don't have that addiction anymore. I actually haven't, like, cared about Fortnite for the last year. It's crazy how the game became this small, niche, really fun game that only you and your friends knew about to this corporate marketing scheme. That game has literally lost every single bit of life it had in it. But I do have some stories about my addiction when it was at its worst. And let's just say I'm not proud of them. So this first story was leading up to the surgery that I had on my shoulder. I'd like to think that I was having these thoughts just because I was scared of going to surgery. One of my biggest concerns about going into surgery was the fact that I wasn't going to be able to play Fortnite for a very long time. I wasn't going to be able to use my arm for a month to a month and a half. When I learned that news, I was like, man, I don't know if, man, I don't know if surgery is worth it if I won't be able to play Fortnite for a month. It's so funny to think about how stupid that sounds now, but that was genuine thoughts running through my brain as the 16-year-old that I was at the time. Fortnite really meant a lot to me in my life. And that entire month was probably the saddest part of my life. I sat down every single day in front of my computer. I would look at the Fortnite lobby screen cycling through all my skins, wishing I could just play again. And actually, 2 weeks after the surgery, I decided to try it out. I decided to play, even though my arm wasn't supposed to come out of my sling within the first month of surgery. I took my arm out, I put my keyboard on my lap, trying to play with it like I was Daquan. And then I remember taking it out of the sling and just yelling in the most excruciating pain ever. I did all that to play Fortnite. It is so cringy to think about. Now this one's pretty funny. This is about the day that I skipped school so I could play Fortnite. So one day my sister and I were walking to school and I dropped her off at the middle school, and then I went into the high school, and then I remember just like, I don't want to do this today. I somehow walked straight out of the high school without getting noticed and walked all the way back home. I think this was the second day of season 6 of Fortnite. I just wanted to play Fortnite. I just wanted to play the new season. I walked home in the cast iron skillet. I fried up a bunch of tater tots while launching Fortnite up on my computer, ate the tater tots and got on, and I played 2 games. I actually won both of them, which is crazy because I was really bad at Fortnite. After winning the second game, I remember hearing stomps up the stairs, and then my mom came bursting through my room and asked me what I was doing. She was screaming at me because I was home on a school day. I was like, well, I was hungry and there was nothing good to eat at school. There was only Pop-Tarts, so I came home to make tater tots, and then I wanted to play some Fortnite, so I got on. I just wanted to win a couple of games and I was gonna go back to school. That was not the plan at all. And then she told me to get going. Just some good time. And I definitely have a ton of other stories, and they're not about Fortnite addiction per se, but they're just funny stories on Fortnite. Like the time how I was in a squads game and I was screaming at my teammate to revive me, and I was screaming help because somebody was gonna BM me, and my mom thought a fire was going on, and she ran upstairs screaming because she thought something was going on. That's a great story. I'm gonna end the video here. Thanks so much for watching, guys. I gotta go take a massive dump. I just ate a ton of beans, and you know how that goes. Love you guys, and I'll see you in the next video. Peace.